Hello everyone. So in this video again, we have a very interesting question for you pertaining to number system, or sorry, pertaining to base system. So let's take a look. A rational number written in the base 8 is AB dot AB point CD, and where all the digits are non-zero. The same number when written in base 12 is BB dot BA. Find base 10 number of ABC. Okay. So with that said. Initially, since both these numbers are essentially equal, so therefore, part before decimals and part after decimal must be equal. Okay, so let me do one thing. So if we take the before decimal part, here AB, here we have BB. Okay, so 0 1 0 1. Okay, so this was in base 8, this in 12. So if we further break this down, we have 8A plus B equal to 12B plus B. Okay, and now if we talk about the part after the decimal, we have CD 8 again 0 1, again we have BA 0 1, it is 12. This can be written by 8 minus 1 since it's behind decimal, so C by 8. Okay, it won't be 0, right? It will be 0, 2 and 0, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, so C by 8 plus D by 64 will again give us B by 12 plus A by 144. Okay, so if we simplify this particular term, we have 9A or 8A. 8A equal to 12B, so therefore which can be further written as A equal to 3 by 2B. Okay, now putting this value in this particular equation, we have 8 3B by 32 equal to C by 8 plus D by 64. So if we multiply both, so LCM of 32, 8 and 64 will be 64. If we multiply both the sides by 64, it will simply give us 6B equal to 8C plus D. Okay. Now, here one thing to be kept in mind is that A comma B will lie between 1 to 7 since it's an 8 base. Okay, so there are 1 to 7 digits, so they will lie between 1 to 7. They must be single non-zero digits as such. So now again we have A equal to 3 by 2B. So basically, twice of A should be equal to thrice of B. Okay, so now how many values actually satisfy the same? Suppose A is equal to 1, then 2. Suppose A is 1, B is 2 by 3, not satisfied. Suppose A is 2, 4, not satisfied. Let's say A is 3. 3 to just 6, B will become 2. So one value of A comma B would be 3 comma 2. Another value for A comma B would be multiple of 3 itself. Suppose A is 6, 6 to j 12 by 3, 4, 6 comma 4. So only these two numbers basically satisfy the given condition. Okay, so this is what satisfies the given condition. So with that said, now let's just test all these things out. Okay, so let me test all these figures out. Suppose I'll take b equal to 2 and put this particular value in this particular number. Okay, or let me just put it here. So if I put b equal to 2, so it would give me, let me just solve this here in this particular part. So 6 2 are 12 equal to 8c plus d. Okay, so therefore c equal to 1 and d equal to 4, the equation satisfies. So this value is valid. Okay, now let me again take d equal to 4 now. So it will be 24 equal to 8c plus d. Okay, so 24. So d cannot be 0, remember, because d, c comma d should lie from 1 to 11. Okay, so 8 2 is 16, 16 plus 8. Okay, we cannot have that because c and d is also there. So c comma d should also lie between 0 to 8, my bad, since they are also a part of 8 ways, right? So the 1 to 7 they should lie. Okay, so it cannot be 0. So this particular condition, suppose we take c equal to 3, so it would mean d equal to 0, which is not justifiable. Suppose we take, okay, now suppose I take c equal to 2, 16, so d will be equal to 8, which is again not satisfied because the value should lie between 1 to 7. So this particular value is invalid. So here we can see value of a being 3, b being 2, c being 1 from here equal to 1, and d equal to 4 from here. So this is our value. So therefore a into b into c will be given by 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, so it's okay, number ABC. So 3 to 1, basically 321 is our final answer. So I hope this thing is clear to you, how we came about with the solution of the same. So kindly go through the problem in general and try to solve it on your own, so that you can get a better understanding on the question itself. And with the help of the video as a reference, you can try and solve this question on your own, so that you can get a better idea on how to tackle this kind of questions. So basic idea here is that the point, the part before the decimal and after decimal will be equal, and all we did was to just keeping the base fixed, that is to basic, that is from digit 1 to 7, so that we can have a fixed answer. So that's it, I'm signing out. Thank you so much.